वेलकम टू एनालॉग कम्युनिकेशन प्लेलिस्ट। आई प्रोफेसर रितेश दोलकिया इज गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू वीएसबी डीमॉड्यूलेशन इन दिस सेशन। सो वी आर डील विथ टू अंडरस्टैंड वीएसबी डीमॉड्यूलेशन ओवर हियर। नाउ सी, इन माय प्रीवियस सेशन आई हैव एक्सप्लेन यू हाउ वी जनरेट वीएसबी मॉड्यूलेटेड सिग्नल। सो इन दैट वी हैव सीन व्हाट इज दैट वीएसबी फिल्टर विच इज देयर एट आउटपुट साइड and how much bandwidth that we translate, right? So that is what the case which we have already seen it in my previous session. So here let us have a quick recap of that VSB modulated signal. So here first I'll plot that signal's response at modulation side. So if you observe that signal and its frequency response, then here there is a frequency and this is amplitude, right? Now if I say here we have fc frequency, right, then you will be finding like, see here there is fc plus fm and here there is fc minus fm, right? And in this, if you observe response of the signal, then that response will be something like this in case of VSB modulation, right? So here if you observe this bandwidth for VSB modulation, then for VSB modulation this will be additional bandwidth which is there than SSB. So for SSB we send only this band, right? But for VSB we send this upper sideband plus this vestigial sideband, right? So here this frequency will be FC plus FB, or one can say FB minus F, FC minus FB. So total bandwidth that will be FM plus FB, which is there with vestigial sideband. Now if I say this is my signal which is S of F, if I say this is my signal which is S of F, right, then this S of F that is having FC plus FF FC plus F component as well as FC minus F component of modulating signal, right? So here if I write this modulated signal in terms of frequency, then that will be AC by 2 into M of FC F plus FC and modulated signal into F minus FC of H of F, right? See, this is what the response which we have it at modulated signal. Now our agenda is to detect that modulating signal which is there in this modulated signal. So how to do this? So let us do that step by step. So here for that, see, we have VSB signal. Let us say we have a VSB signal over here, and that signal is S of F in terms of frequency and S of T in terms of time domain. Over here first we give it to product modulator. Over here first we give it to product modulator, and in product modulator second input is carrier signal. So that is AC dash cos of 2 pi FCT, right? And this is my output of this product modulator. Let us say this output is V of T in terms of time domain, and in terms of time domain VSB signal is S of T, right? So what will be my output V of T? As per product modulator, my output V of T, so output of product modulator, that is V of T, and that has to be V of T is equals to multiplication of both in terms of time domain. So S of T into AC dash cos of 2 pi FCT. In time domain, it will be like this, right? Now let us identify this response in terms of frequency domain. Then we will be having proper idea, like what is my V of F. So if I want V of F right over here, then how to identify this? Let us try to understand this. So in frequency domain, this will be V of F, and that is AC dash by 2 into, now see, there will be two components. One is addition of frequency and one is subtraction of frequency. So here, instead of S of T, now I'll be writing S of F minus FC plus S of F plus FC. See, this is what my frequency response, as in frequency response multiplication, that will be having two components, addition of frequency and subtraction of frequency. So if I say frequency associated over here will be F, then F minus FC, F plus FC, that is what frequency response, frequency domain representation, right? And amplitude will get half. So that is how frequency domain response will be there. Now you observe this S of F, that is given, that is AC by 2 into M of F plus FC plus M of F minus FC into H of F. So if I substitute this over here, then just focus about this term. See, I'm writing it first, AC dash by 2 into, now you see for this term, it will be AC by 2 into, instead of F, now I need to write F minus FC, right? So this is what this term, S of F minus FC, right? Where I have just placed F is equals to F minus FC, right? So that will be this term. Then plus, now replace this S of F plus FC with this. So over here, now this term will be AC by 2 into M of, now I need to place F plus FC instead of F. So this will be, now we need to separate out all those terms so it will be a bit more clear, right? So AC dash into AC by 4, that will be this term. Now that into, I'm just writing separate terms. So see, this FC and this FC will get cancelled. This will be 2FC, this will be 2FC, and this will be FC, and FC will get cancelled. So I'm just writing M of F term separately. So here, if I say M of F, and this is M of F, right? So let me make it clear. See, this is M of F, and this is even M of F, right? And with that, in multiplication, F minus FC is there. So H of F minus FC, and over here, plus H of F plus FC into M of F. See, this is that term. So these two terms are there. Now separately, this and this term is there. So AC dash by 4 into M of F minus 2FC into H of F minus FC, that is this term, plus AC dash by 4 into M of F plus 2FC into H of F plus FC. See, that is how all terms are there, right? Now all we will be doing is, these are high frequency component. You can see with this, high frequency components are there. So if I pass this through low pass filter, if I pass this V of F through low pass filter, I'll be going to remove these terms, and I can be able to extract this message information, right? So now all we will be doing is just pass this through low pass filter. So what will happen? Let us try to understand this. So as if we pass this through low pass filter, you'll be finding, like, say this is high frequency component, right? So this will get eliminated. But over here, if you see this, this is H of, see, this is what frequency band. So we can say this is H of F that we have with low frequency. So this is what we are passing it after low pass filter. Right. So my output V, if I say it is V0T. So in V0T, this is my output that we will be having. Right. So this V0T, that is my output, and that will be. And that is what my demodulated signal, right? So this is how we can do demodulation of signal. And one thing that one should understand, see, when we transmit signal in VSB, at that time we send upper sideband as well as partially we send lower sideband. And that is what we are representing this with these two components that you can see it over here. And at receiver side, this is my receiver block diagram, right? This is my receiver block diagram. And in this receiver block diagram, you can observe, first we need to have product modulator with carrier signal, and then we just pass it through low pass filter, and you will be extracting this, which is our output, right? So this is the case which we do it in VSB demodulation. In next video, I'll explain you how we can design VSB filter, right? And based on that designing of VSB filter, what will be my modulated and received signal? So all those things that we will see it in next session. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please give your valuable suggestions.